Do you often run into this problem when using Nano Banana Pro? You pay an expensive monthly subscription, your generations are still limited, and when you finally get an image you like, changing even a small detail burns through your credits. If you're tired of these limits, you need to watch today's video. A few days ago, Black Forest Labs released Flux 2. This isn't just an upgrade, it introduces two game-changing features: native multi-image referencing and directive instructional editing. That means you no longer have to painfully paint masks for inpainting or spend hours training Allura to make targeted edits. You can point and change, and even generate coherent character sequences. Best of all, it's free and open source. It's been optimized with FP8, so even if your GPU only has 8GB VRAM, 16GB plus recommended, and you have enough system memory, you can run it locally. If your VRAM is low, system RAM can help compensate. Runs may take longer, but you can schedule batch jobs and don't need to watch the screen the whole time. In this video, I'll walk you step by step through installing and using Flux 2, from beginner to advanced, to achieve AI art freedom on your own machine. Hello everyone, welcome to Smart Vision. This channel focuses on practical, locally runnable AI knowledge and workflows that can help you make money. If you enjoy my videos, please like, share, and subscribe. Your support is my greatest motivation to keep creating. For more downloadable examples and useful workflows, follow my Patreon. Now, let's begin today's episode. Before we install, a quick summary of what makes Flux 2 strong. Functionally, it covers many of the same features as Nano Banana Pro. The locally runnable version has lower numeric precision, so it's not identical to the cloud model, but it can handle most everyday image generation tasks. 1. Directive editing. Previously, changing a character's clothing required inpainting and mask painting a hassle. Flux 2 blurs the line between text to image and image to image. You give it an image and say change the background to a forest, and it will edit the background while preserving character details. Native multi-reference. Before, to lock in a character's appearance, we had to train Allura. Flux 2 accepts up to 10 reference images at once and automatically extracts features so you can render the same character across different scenes easily. 3. Native FP8 optimization. This is crucial for local users. The team provides an FP8 build and combined with GGUF quantization. VRAM usage can drop dramatically, models around 12GB. Offloading some layers to system RAM explains why even 8GB cards can run larger images. Okay, onto the practical steps. We'll run Flux 2 with Comfy UI, the most flexible and well-optimized option right now. Download the portable build from GitHub, unzip, and it's ready to use, or install the Windows build. If you already have Comfy UI, update it, Flux 2 needs the latest core. Download the City 96 Flux 2 GGUF model from Hugging Face. File size is roughly 12-16GB. The 12GB Q2 GGUF version is the lifesaver for low VRAM users. Don't grab the wrong file. Put the downloaded model into Comfy UI, Models, Unit. Also download the text, encoder, and Flux 2 VAE, and place them in the appropriate folders. Comfy UI provides a Flux 2 template workflow. Open it and replace the UNet node with UNet Loader GGUF, pointing to the model you downloaded. If it can't find the model, check that the GGUF is in Comfy UI, Models, UNet, and restart Comfy UI. Also, set clip to run on CPU, because clip can be very large, some clip variants approach to 18GB, and most consumer GPUs can't hold that. First demo, generating a scene with multiple characters, while keeping character consistency, a signature Nano Banana Pro feature. Flux 2 accepts up to 10 reference images, so we can input 10 people photos. The template workflow includes a node for 2 reference images. To add more, chain additional reference nodes, fill in the prompt and set the output image size. Because local RAM and VRAM are limited, start small and upscale later. See my previous videos for upscaling methods. The result was mediocre. Only 3 characters appeared. 2 had decent consistency, the 3rd looked like a random extra character. This may be because I used Q4.1 quantization, and my prompts weren't specific enough. I increased control strength and tried again. 10 characters is still hard for the local version. I tried with 5 characters. Results worsened. Some characters lost consistency. One girl wasn't reproduced correctly, and a female knight ended up wearing a crown. The best results were with 4 characters, the consistency was fairly high. Conclusion here. On a local 16GB VRAM setup running the Q4 Flux 2 model, I can reliably place about 3-4 characters in one image. If you need more characters, use Flux 2 Pro or Nano Banana Pro in the cloud to save time and credits. Note: generation time grows with reference count. One reference might take to 2 minutes, while 10 refs can take to 25 minutes on my rig. Next, editing existing images. I tested changing a character's pose, background, and clothing. I used a photograph of a girl and asked her to perform a reference pose. My prompt: the girl from image 1 is wearing the armor from image 2, posing like the girl in image 3, and standing in the scene from image 4, with the armor bearing the words, "Thanksgiving Day." Okay, let's check the results. Everything matched except the pose. When I added OpenPose input to control the pose, the posture became closer, but the character identity degraded. With more constraints, the model becomes harder to control. Pose control still needs work. Try several runs to find the best outcome. Then I tested sketch to image. I drew a few rough sketches in Paint. Well, Flux 2 followed the sketches quite well. With appropriate prompts, it can turn rough concept sketches into coherent scenes. I also tested generating explanatory illustrations, a hallmark Nano Banana Pro feature. Since local Flux 2 is fully offline, you must provide a detailed instruction. I asked it to create an illustration of photosynthesis in plants. I first used Gemini Flash to draft a detailed prompt, then fed that prompt to Flux 2. Okay, the explanatory text and illustration were both reasonable. You can try this yourself. Stylistic control. Because describing style only by text is tricky, you can use LoRAs to guide Flux 2's visual style or unlock new looks. Search for style LoRAs on Civitai and choose a LoRA whose base model is Flux 2. Flux 2 is new, so available, LoRAs are still limited. Download a LoRA, place it in ComfyUI, Models, LoRAs, then add a LoRA loader node in your workflow. If it doesn't appear, restart ComfyUI. How to run Flux 2 without babysitting. Flux 2 runs slowly, so it's impractical to watch every run. Instead, prepare a text file where each line is a prompt for one image. Add a node to read this text file, and a counter to process one prompt at a time to avoid out of memory. Set the number of images you want and run. For higher reliability, set it to generate many variations and pick the best ones. This workflow lets you schedule batch jobs and walk away while your PC generates images. For an art book, prepare detailed prompts, such as generated with Gemini for each scene, and list them line by line. I also add an Olama node install, use instructions on my Patreon, to help craft better prompts for Flux 2. Summary. The LoVRAM local version of Flux 2 satisfies most everyday use cases, clothing edits, adding text, a few characters in one scene, and free batch generation. For very complex scenes, you'll need more trial runs and prompt tuning. If you want to save time, use Nano Banana Pro or Flux 2 Pro in the cloud. That's it for this episode. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe. All workflows used in this video are uploaded to my Patreon for free. Just follow me there to download and support the channel. See you next time. Bye.